Hello everyone, welcome to Simulaciones Finitas, your engineering YouTube channel where we do a lot of simulation. In today's video, we will see an example of how to consider weld joint efficiency and pressure of vessels using finite element analysis. So let's say we have this pressure vessel with these dimensions and material, and we want to address the effects of the welding process in our design. One way is to consider the defects that you might find in the weld, but there is another way, and it's to use a joint efficiency instead. It depends on the code we're working with, the amount of inspection, and the specification of the material. So let's say, for example, if we use ASME Section A Division 2, it depends on joint category, extent of NDT, weld thickness, welding process, and surface temperature. For Division 1, it depends on weld type and extent of NDT. So how do we address properly a joint efficiency? That's what we are going to see, and we found a reference from an ASME publication made by Trevor Seipp, and that's what we are going to see. I hope you enjoyed it. Before diving into the details of the simulation, we need to clarify some previous statements. The first one is related to geometry, where we have an outside diameter of 120 inches. Secondly, the vessel has 1 inch of weld thickness, which at the end shall define the bandwidth for the welding zone. Because it is a different material from the pipe, this zone will have to behave accordingly. Third, we do not have any openings nor discontinuities in our model, and that is the reason why we do not expect local primary stresses on the model. Lastly, the internal pressure is the only applied load on the model. And now we can move on to the material behavior. There are three types of stresses analysis for vessels according to ASME Section A Division 2. The first one is the elastic stress analysis. It works based on the assumption that material behaves fully elastic. In other words, you can increase the load after yielding, and the strain will be proportional to Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio. The second model is the limit load, and it considers a yielding point. When it reaches this point, it behaves fully plastic. And the last model is the elastic plastic, which works with the through stress strain behavior of the material. Now, if we consider a joint efficiency of 0.85, it will reduce the strength for the second and third analysis type. For the elastic zone, it will remain almost the same, but it reduces the yielding point by a factor of 0.85 on all further points, both for the fully plastic and plastic strength behavior. Now we can move on to the simulation. Okay, now let's continue with the review of the results. Here we have the elastic stress analysis, which works with stress classification lines. I'm not going into the details of the methodology, but just let's suppose this is the stress distribution through the thickness of your pressure vessel. This stress distribution has two main components. The first one is the primary stress, which might be either local or global, and the bending stress, which might be either primary or secondary, right? So that's the stress distribution that you have at the end with a linearized stress. Now we have the allowable strength of the material. For this case, is 25.3 KSI. And this tells us that when we exceed as principal stress this value, then the model fails. So when we have a primary stress higher than this, our model doesn't work. Here we have the model with the pipe stress as defined as an elastic material, and this geometry works with solid elements. If you see the mesh, here the mesh is fine enough, you see, to have six elements through the thickness. Here we have the pressure and the setting conditions to have the same model that we stated at the beginning of the problem. Now, the results considering the linearized equivalent stress is this. We have a membrane around 25,600 psi. But if we consider the weld effect inner problem, then we have to reduce the strength of the material by 0.85 times. So it means we will have this value as a maximum. And we need to find what is the internal pressure that limits the model. So we did some parameterization using this model, right? And the results are the following. Here we have an internal pressure around 407 psi, which results in a linearized stress membrane around this value. So those are the results that we had from an elastic stress analysis. Let's continue with the limit load and the elastic plastic. Okay, now when we do a limit load analysis, we need to define carefully the material properties and the load. The material properties, as we saw earlier, are an elastic, fully plastic material, as you can see here. And the weld is amplified by a factor of 0.85 times. So you define this in your model here, for example. We have the limit load for the weld and the limit load for the pipe. And then we need to amplify the load. The load must be amplified by a factor of 1.5 times the internal pressure for this example. And when we do this in the model here, we see if we are able to reach convergence. As you can see here, we have those convergence problems. And then we have to reduce the internal pressure in order to see where is the maximum internal pressure that allowed us to reach convergence. For your case, it was 624 psi. So we finally have to reduce this internal pressure by the factor that we use in the load case. And that's the load that we reach with the limit load analysis. Well, finally, for the elastic plastic analysis, the methodology is similar to the limit load. We defined the materials, the load, and found a maximum internal pressure. The material is defined according to the true stress-strain behavior for the pipe, for the weld. We defined this in our model, like this here, for example. This weld is an elastic plastic behavior, and this pipe is also an elastic plastic. And we introduce an internal pressure according to a factor beta, which we will use as 2.4 times the internal pressure. And this is our input parameter. Here, we will see if we are able to reach or not convergence. As expected, we do not reach convergence. And then we have to go through iterative process for the internal pressure, where we finally find this value. So this value will be the result for the elastic plastic analysis. Okay. So with that in mind, we have already seen all those three methodologies through the use of finite element analysis. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please subscribe, give it a like if you like, leave your comments, and give us any feedback. thank you for your time again, and hope I see you soon. Bye.